We are here reacting to a band called Until I Wake.
Who I've never actually heard of.
You've never heard these guys?
No, I think the band name, I mean, again, it sounds like every band name
ever.
Exactly.
So
who knows?
Not knocking them, but yeah.
That many wakes and until
things are waking up and falling asleep all the time in the hardcore scene. So no one fucking knows what's going on. And you know what they're also doing? They're sinking. And these motherfuckers are still sinking.
Yeah, dude.
So they've been sinking for a while now.
So we got this angry face up here on top. You reckon this band...
I've been listening to
these guys. Any shout-outs to a song by them that you can think of?
Oh, off the top of my head, I can't think of like one that really... I've got like three or four on my playlist over the last couple of years.
This is a brand newy.
Yeah, this is a brand newy. They've got like a really distinct clean vocal sound.
Okay.
So it should be good. Yeah, this one only dropped last week. So until I Wake, still sinking. Should we dig in?
Let's fucking dig in.
Let's do it. Let's give our opinions.
Oh, the blare straight off the top, dude. Oh, Hell Architects riff.
Hell yeah.
Layered vocals, man. Wage war as fuck. Oh, 2012 synth vibes.
Open up. I like that.
They're
even doing shit in the chorus.
Yeah, dude. That's so Architects, that old Architects, that riff, man. Pause that. We're going back. I love a re-listen. And that was
re-listenable, my man.
So some call-outs quickly while we do a little mid-pause.
We'll do
the little dick teasers in this song where there's just a little it does the next little fucking thing. They're doing that so well.
It's the songwriting that was so sorely missing in the last react we did with the new Parkway song.
Yeah, dude.
You know, like we said, it was just like, all right, you know, but nothing changed throughout the song.
Yeah.
It's just like, go, go, stop. Whereas this, it's like, even halfway through the chorus, they're like, empty, back
bang.
In.
And, like, and it's like, again, that's it. I mean, look, we've heard this format of metal song
a million times, right?
So then the ways that you can make little subtle changes to make it something that stands out is so important, dude, to get a song like this so far that catches your attention.
Yeah.
The Architects fucking Lost Forever, Lost Together riff is crazy through this song, how much that like stands out as something.
Tuned a lot lower though, actually.
Yeah.
This is quite low. So it sounds a bit more, it doesn't sound like a direct ripoff.
No, not at all. But it's just got that same groove. That kind of like building. So good.
Yeah.
I can't put my finger on, there's two... distinct sounds with the screamer and the clean singer. That reminds me of something.
The clean singer has always stood out in this band for me.
Yeah.
Like in off their older album, I can't remember what it's called. It's got like a blue cover. There's one song in particular where like the clean vocals were just like on point. I mean, the whole song's on point, but I was just like, wow, that fucking, that's hooky, that's catchy, man. Like, that's so
They kind of remind me of a bit of like early Memphis May Fire.
A little
like,
bit, that's, hey.
There's a bit of that really good vibe between the screaming and riffs and then that big, powerful, uplifting chorus. Yeah. I think there's like early...
A little bit more new medley.
Kind of course. But yeah, that following that same formula of kind of blending that faster, like riffy style with the big, massive uplifting chorus, man. They do that really well. Yeah. So I think, yeah, we've looped back. I want to hear this fucking absolute beat down again.
Let's get beat down, shall we? Very tough.
The drums through that was fucking...
And then there's the synth in the background that sat nicely, like, kind of added a bit of extra, like, tempo to it, I guess.
Patient 67 a bit, really, as well, this chorus. Yeah.
A bit...
Is it going to go again?
Nah, I think that's it.
Oh, yeah, okay. Going to have the big 30 second.
Nah, I think that's it, which is cool. That's fine. I was going to say, we were like, oh, I don't know what band it is. I don't know what band it's reminding me of. Icy Stars.
Yes. Yeah,
it sounds a lot like a newer, lower tuned version of Icy Stars.
Yeah. That was good, man.
Very cool. Look, Until I Wake, boys.
We always start with the production quality.
Very good. Yeah, very good.
That was solid as. The drums really stood out for me in that song. Well, we talked about the riff in the little break there, but the guitars were awesome, but the drums, that snare was fucking crispy as.
Yeah.
The production was really good, but yeah, drums really stood out for me as
drums
adding
stood out.
A big positive addition to a good song that really noticeable how good and clean the drums were. Because this is the thing, man, like guitar technology in that these days and the way to record that is getting a lot easier. And then drums is the thing that has been lagging a little bit. And you can notice sometimes with some of these bands where the vocals and the guitars are really good, but they struggle to get that drum sound right.
Yeah.
That's the thing, that there's still so many parts of the instrument.
Yeah.
And you can fuck up a snare or fuck up a kick quite easily, and it changed the entire dynamic or feel of a song.
Exactly.
So getting the drums right like they did in that song is so important.
Yeah, 100%. Because it forms the foundation of a mix, I guess. In this case here, I will say, for my liking, the guitars weren't probably piercing enough.
Yeah.
Like they probably sat a little bit too far back in the mix.
Yep.
Like overall,
especially when you have the synths and stuff as well going on.
Yeah, but that's probably
why
they did it, because I was just about to lead in. The synths in like a lot of the breakdowns there, like the movement the synths had, like if you listen back to the actual the breakdown there, if you listen to the synth, you'll hear it like go up and down in pitch, which is can be quite distracting. But that works during a breakdown, which is just a zero note, like one note. But that's probably why they actually mixed it, and they also mixed it probably more so to have the focus on the vocals, which is what a lot of bands are doing. They're making it more pop sensibility when it comes to their mixes and stuff like that. So hey, look, man, you can't knock it.
Nah.
You can't knock that song. Still sinking, man. I mean, like I'm gonna have to go and properly check out this album, because if that's any indicator.
Definitely.
There's going to be some big songs on there. So,
well, we're back to Donkey Kicks for this one. This one's definitely Donkey Kick in the China and Donkey Kick realm after we had to get out the Lars Ulrich snare for the Parkway rating.
Yeah.
I'll go first on this one, man. Yeah, that was a very solid... I'm going to go 13 and a half on that one.
You're going to go 13 and a half?
Yeah, I think that was 13 and a half. Yeah. Again, there was a couple of bits that made it a really enjoyable song and kind of stood out a bit. Overall, it's not a complete game changer. It's not in that 15 to 17 realm for me. I think it's still, fairly what we come to expect from a good modern band.
I think so far the only 15 that we've given out would be the I Prevail song.
And I gave out a 15 for that Dead Skin song just because I thought that one to me.
So I was talking about Aggregate.
Oh, Aggregate, yeah. I think maybe that.
I think that got a 15. One. Ended up getting a 15.
But
so you're going to go 13.5?
Yeah, 13.5 for this.
So you've kicked, you've done 13 Donkey Kicks and you've kind of half extended your leg, but you're like, I'm not going to kick anymore. I'm getting a bit tired.
Again, maybe that, again, I always think about this, but like that little last 30 second thing. There was another little breakdown there at the end just to bring back that heaviness because we had three really big choruses, the one sort of beat down thing in the middle. Yeah. I think if that was a 4:20 song with a big like breakdown riffy outro at the end, bang, really there's a 14:15 song.
But then again, like, you know, you say that and I agree, I would have much rather that, but like we don't know how this sits in the context of the album.
Of course.
Maybe the next song like that comes after this one is Filth.
It's huge. So yeah, you don't want to go huge.
So you don't want to go huge and then huge again. So
absolutely.
I'm going to give it a 14.
Yep.
So that would make...
basically a 14 aggregate.
That would make it... Yeah. That would basically make it a 14 aggregate, which is...
Not bad, man.
14 out of 17. That's... very strong.
Can't complain with that at all. So
very strong.
If you've got some other ideas for reactions of songs that's come out pretty recently or that you think we've just never heard and you would love to see our opinions on it, chuck it down in the comments, man. We love getting that feedback back and trying to give shit that you guys want to hear as well rather than us just coming up with this shit as we go.
Yeah. Hey, look, if it's the new Spice Girls song, please get at me because I fucking love the Spice Girls.
And tell us your rating as well. Like, we want to know what you guys think, right?
We want everyone's ratings.
Let's see if we're so far off the mark and you guys are thinking these are absolute 11s.
They might think they're 10ers, you know? Yeah. Isn't it funny now that a 10er is like... I mean, because I guess if you think about it, 17, if you're bringing that down to a 5, like a 5-star rating or a 5 rating, a 10er or anything lower than 10 would be like...
3.
A 3.
Yeah, like 2.5.
A 2.5, 3. So... You know, but we go 17 because we don't fuck with round numbers.
No, that's right.
At all. So
we odd up in this bitch.
Odd numbers only.
Thick, ropey oddness.
So 14.
14 aggregate.
Beautiful.
Until I wake, still sinking.
Still sinking. Love it.
Peace out.